Mexico trip was the best trip I've ever been on in my life. It was amazing, inspirational, adventurous. It was incredible. It ticked all the boxes. It was incredible. I'd say the food was unique, to say the least. I mean, you can see a couple of clips about now. And, yeah, the bug-off especially, that was kinky. I mean, their five-star dining is completely different to ours, but, you know, simple bug here and there, never hurt anyone. Unless you're John Cain, when you do a fat bug-off with 12 bugs in a row, doing a bunch of tequila shots, that was crazy.
They were disgusting, but in my head I was trying to keep my sort of composure, like, yeah, these ain't too bad. In my head I'm like, oh, these are terrible. I'm like, these are quite nice.
You were manning up, oh, come on, come on. How's that feel? Don't swallow it, chew it, brace the taste.
He's going for seconds! Oh. Eating that bug was literally the worst thing I've ever done in my life. Like, you can see on my face, that was no bullshit. That was the worst thing I've ever done in my life.
I'd say it was disgusting, man. Me and Scotty were struggling to eat those. Next thing you know, I get roped into doing the bug off challenge.
Welcome to the Freerun crazy bug off challenge. I'm here with the one and only John Cain.
Everybody, John Cain.
Why am I doing this?
We have the lovely Katie McDonald right here in the house. Uno, dos, tres. Go for it!
She's just necked every single one of them! She's just taken them all!
She's reaching for the water. She's going for the water.
Do it.
Do it.
Him. Do him. Oh no, that's a draw. Yes.
And I'd just like to say, I've seen the footage back and I was without doubt a clear winner.
Katie was cool actually. I thought she would kind of hold back a little bit, but she didn't. She rocked it out, she did some serious tricks and she kept up, and she was cool actually. She fit in really well with the team.
Yeah, it was wicked having Katie with us. It's quite rare that we have a sort of girl join us on our adventures, but, and obviously, you know, it was the first time I'd even never met her, and she was like rocking along with us on the adventure, and yeah, she was wicked, man. Katie was real cool. Little addition to the crew.
Did you see in Mexico, like, what things just took your breath away?
There was a couple of moments, man. Like, one I actually mentioned to Chase, where we were just, like, obviously driving across Mexico and just driving through the countryside. You kind of have to stop for a moment and think, hang on, I'm touring across Mexico in a 14-seater minibus with the most epic people known to man. And you kind of just look around and you take in life. And that was a big moment for me, just because everything around me was beautiful, the place.
Well, I literally flew straight from New York to Mexico, but unfortunately I was in New York as the Hurricane Sandy was happening. So I had no power for like 3 or 4 days, you know, this hurricane sort of smashing so much stuff, destroying everything. And literally, finally, when we get the power on, I've got like missed calls, missed messages from Chase saying, bro, man, there's a job in Mexico, you know, like, I need to hear back from you because, you know, we need to confirm it like now.
Any words, John Cain?
Not really, I've just been in a hurricane and a snowstorm. I'm happy to be in Mexico. 11 years of my life training, trying to achieve one thing, and that's double corks on flat. And I've been drilling it and drilling it, drilling it in the gym, just like every session, first move I did. And then it came to shoot day and they asked me, you know, they saw me sort of doing it in the rehearsal day. So I sort of, you know, I managed to drop a double cork on the rehearsal day. And then so the director saw that and he was like, I really want you to do that on the shoot. And I was like, but I can't do it in a suit. Like, it's crazy. You know, in shoes and like, yeah, it was crazy. But yeah, man, I was just feeling it. I was buzzing off everyone. Kane, Scott, Mike, they were all giving me so much, like, you know, they were really pushing me to do it. So I was like, fuck it, I'll go for it. And it was cool.
I've got to say, the traveling for me was without doubt my favorite part of the trip. Especially when we're rowing down the river in sort of kayaks.
You're looking good, boys, but you ain't got that.
I know.
You ain't got that.
But in my defense, I am waiting to buy a diesel.
That's the hack.
Oh. Next thing you know, there's a giant waterfall. We find an amazing place to sort of do some flips off into the water. I mean, I've never had the chance to do sort of high jumping into water, but that's probably one of the most beautiful places to go do it, I could imagine.
Whoa. Spot on, yeah. Good lad.
Freerun for life?
Freerun forever.
Louder.
Freerun for life.
Louder.
Freerun for life, motherfuckers.
Battery.
The worst part is we had to wear these life vests. So every time you hit the water, you kind of come back up.
Whoa.
Whoa. The world famous parkour house. It was the world famous parkour house. It was pretty sick, to be fair. Our boy Andreas was an absolute legend. Andreas, we love you, man. Thank you so much for everything. Yeah, it was good, man. Tricked out with some sick parkour stuff. It is on its way up, so if you're thinking about going to Mexico, get in touch with Andreas from the parkour house, because it is pretty sick. I would just employ an interior decorator to work on some of the details.
My favourite move in the commercial has to be the front of the roof. Oh, mad. And the reason for that is because basically the directors wanted us to jump it. We didn't even prep it or anything. We got up and then, you know those gaps where you're like, okay, yeah, we can do that. And you get up high and you're like, okay, that's bigger than I thought.
You have to do, I ain't gonna lie, that's a big old drop, that.
So yeah, we rocked it, and then Kane thought it'd be cool to put a front in there, and I was like, you're a crackhead. And then a couple more jobs later, I'm doing it with him. So it's nice to actually push yourself with your boys and actually, you know, producing some epic, crazy content for this commercial.
And sometimes when me and Mike are together, we just come up with these random ideas or stupid games. But I was walking past this shop and it basically had all these mannequins out the front. So I said to Mike, oh, let's just kind of pretend to be mannequins and scare people as they walk past.
You ain't nothing but a troublemaker, girl.
You have me hooked again from the minute you sat down. The way you got
to be honest, we didn't really scare many people, we just looked like idiots, but I got one or two people.
I was putty in your hands. I don't know if I had the chance to stand.
And yeah. I mean, next we know, the police are called and there's been a disturbance.
Oh, he's over for this
one. Police are coming.
So luckily, me and Mike went and got our bags from set, so we wasn't about, but the police were scouting us, and we felt like we was literally wanted for the police. Apart from like the bug off, the mannequin game, the constantly scaring, literally you cannot even walk around the corner and feel safe when you're with the boys. Literally, there's somebody always trying to scare you every 5 seconds.
Check this out.
Have you said like?
Oh,
fuck you!
Here's my boys, legends.
Invited out there by our guys Antonio, Maria, Jose, and the director Pepe, all a bunch of super legends, man. We were really, really lucky to work with such a cool group of guys. But when we'd finished, it was like, right, this is us now, we're going traveling. It's a pure adventure and it's all on us.
Your back as you came through the door, and they fucking have his back on the door, don't they?
True story.
I've been saying it.
Now I'm a cat, now I'm a bat.
Stunning!
Yes! Love that shit.
Good lad.
The only blip in the trip that kind of was a bit of a downside for me is we were trying some all 720s.
All 7s, they're going to be there, right? I'm not dropping it till it's there.
And the later it got, the sort of more tired I'd get. So I gave the last one final attempt. I kind of almost got the 720 spin round, but it was just like a bit too low, so I kind of landed on my ankle a bit dodgy. And yeah, it just gave me a bit of trouble for the rest of the trip.
Whoa!
Bro, that was nearly there.
You all right, Kane?
Scott was there with his oil, giving me a good old ankle massage, making sure everything was all better.
Fixing my boy up, man. Fixing my boy up.
I was a little bit worried about driving through Mexico City when we brought the van back, because already our boy Socks had got off to a pretty bad start and sort of totaled it into another parked car. So I was a little bit worried.
Yeah, so we found some mad spiders in the jungle, like some huge ones that Kane decided he wanted to destroy.
It's the spider.
I don't want to see this.
Oh my god.
Pet stroke the spider.
Ah!
Actually grab it.
Oh, man. Worked out nicely.
We were living in the jungle. We didn't even see the place. We rocked up at night and you couldn't see anything.
We're gonna wear our shades because that's freaking bright.
But you just could hear the sounds and like even the smell and the warmth, the humidity. Oh, it was just beautiful, and we woke up, came out of the like little sort of, it was like living in Harry Potter or something like that. It was beautiful, just amazing.
Crikey, Kane, that looks like a fucking little El Mago.
They've got pretty serious teeth. They use them for cutting through all kinds of shit. Mostly dog food.
The bird cave, that was mental. It was like a scene out of that Alan Hitchcock movie. That was mad. I thought it was going to get eaten.
Scene out of whose movie?
It's not Alan Hitchcock. What's his name?
Alfred Hitchcock.
Alfred Hitchcock. It's like a scene Alex. Out of Alfred.
Chase kind of dared me to let this giant sort of millipede. I don't even know what it is.
Why am I doing this?
It's another. It's the second.
Oh, it looks
Kane,
rainbow,
it's the
mate.
Second it's free run bug off challenge.
No idea, but yeah, crawl on my arm. It literally felt disgusting.
That feels disgusting.
It's just tickling. No, don't freak.
It feels fucking disgusting, boys.
In a weird way, it was kind of quite nice. It was like tickly, but because you knew it was some skanky fat bug on your hand,
quick, get off me. Get off me.
Hang about. Get hang about, Kate, for the challenge.
Get off
going, Kate,
going.
Hang about.
Oh, I've probably just staying to take
like
a little nap.
My arm.
You're starting
Chase.
To enjoy it, AJ.
That was fucking sick, dude. We created Freerun a long time ago, and it was all about sharing the inspiration and sharing the love and showing people, you know, what you can do when you sort of take this practice into your life. And going to Mexico and meeting all the locals out there and just seeing how so many of them said, like, you know, you guys are one of the main reasons why we started. That to me is, it really is incredible. And you know, having some of the athletes come up to you and say, you know, you're the reason why I started, that's amazing. Because like I say, you know, we've all got our inspirations. Jackie Chan pushed us, and if I met him, I'd say thank you. And you know, and the guys had that same love for us, and we had the same love back. So you know what, it's cool to see the Freerun family strong again and rocking worldwide. So it's amazing, man, it really is. Freerun worldwide, baby, for life.